Hello and welcome to Notebook. As you can know, this session is all about a very important chapter, acids, bases, and salts. Before we go into the depth of the chapter, look around you. If you didn't know, let me tell you, acids and bases are present almost everywhere. They are used to make foods and beverages, soaps and detergents, explosives, fertilizers and pesticides, paints, plastics, and even paper. That was all about what we see around us. Now, let us look within ourselves, shall we? Ever heard someone say that they are suffering from acidity? Yes, that refers to a condition where there is an excessive acid production in the stomach, causing heartburn. Moreover, our blood is slightly basic. Our bodily proteins, as you know, are made up of amino acids. Even the letters in our genetic code, namely A, T, G, and C's, are nothing but the nucleic bases. Wasn't that exciting? Come, let us learn more about acids, bases, and salts. Look how we have divided the chapter into six main topics for your better understanding, each focusing on an essential topic. So welcome to the introductory session of this chapter, where we shall try to understand basics of acids and bases. To define, acids are substances which have a sour taste and can turn blue litmus paper red. But hey, be very cautious. Do not even try to taste acids from your school laboratory, as they are very, very powerful and corrosive. Just trust us on the fact that acids taste sour. On the other hand, bases are the substances which have a bitter taste and can turn red litmus blue. Additionally, they are mostly soapy and slippery to touch. Acids are classified on the basis of their sources as organic acids and mineral acids. Organic acids are the ones which are sourced from plants and animals. These naturally occurring acids are weak acids and cause little or no harm to living organisms. For example, tomatoes contain oxalic acid, whereas lemon contains citric acid, ants make formic acid, etc. Find out about more of such organic acids and their sources from this chart. Mineral acids are the ones which are sourced from minerals. They are highly corrosive in nature and cause skin burns. Examples of such acids are sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, carbonic acid, phosphoric acid. Sodium hydroxide or caustic soda, which has the chemical formula NaOH, is used in the manufacture of soap, paper, textile, etc. Potassium hydroxide, also known as caustic potash commercially, has the chemical formula KOH. It is used in alkaline storage batteries and for absorbing carbon dioxide. Next, calcium hydroxide, also known as slaked lime, has the chemical formula CaOH whole twice. Its application is in manufacturing bleaching powder, softening hard water, etc. Similarly, there are other bases like magnesium hydroxide, also known as the milk of magnesia, aluminium hydroxide, and ammonium hydroxide. Find out what their chemical formulae and uses are. Most of the bases are insoluble in water, but some are soluble in water and they are known as alkalis. For example, sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide. So in a way, we can say that bases are classified into alkalis and non-alkalis or simple bases. Remember, all alkalis are bases, but not all bases are alkalis. Look at this sign. What do you think it signifies? It is a caution symbol displayed on containers containing concentrated mineral acids and alkalis. Now, aren't you wondering if alkalis are as dangerous as acids? The answer to your question is yes, they absolutely are. There are some strong bases or alkalis which cause burn and blisters on your skin. They can even dissolve skin. Thus, they are very dangerous and should be handled very, very carefully. In chemistry, acids and bases have been defined differently by three sets of theories. One of them is by a Swedish chemist, Svante Arrhenius. According to this theory, acids are substances which dissociate or ionize to give H+ ions when dissolved in water, and bases are substances which dissociate to give OH- ions when dissolved in water. You can see an example for both the cases. did you notice the H plus and OH minus ions in each case? These ions give acids and bases their characteristic properties, respectively. All we learned was the definition of properties of acids and bases. But how do we know if a substance is acidic or basic? We can do so by using an indicator. And that brings us to the last topic for this session. Indicators, as the name suggests, are substances that specify if a solution is acidic or alkaline. They show a change of color or odor when added to an acidic or alkaline solution. Acid-base indicators are classified into natural and synthetic indicators. Natural indicators are extracted from different kinds of plants. Litmus is a purple-colored dye extracted from a lichen plant. It is used to make a litmus paper, which turns red if a solution is acidic, and a red litmus paper turns purple when the test solution is basic. Red cabbage juice is also used as an acid-base indicator. It remains red in acidic solutions, but changes to green in alkaline solutions. Another commonly used natural acid-base indicator is turmeric juice. Its color remains natural yellow in acidic or neutral medium, but turns reddish-brown in an alkaline medium. Apart from all these, flowers of some plants like China rose, hydrangea, petunia are also used to detect the presence of acids or bases. Moving on, synthetic indicators are synthesized in the laboratories or on an industrial level. Methyl orange gives red color with acidic solutions and yellow with basic or alkaline solutions. Phenolphthalein gives pink or red color in alkaline solutions and is transparent or colorless in acidic ones. Do you remember when we defined indicators, we mentioned that they change their odor too? Let us find out how. Firstly, they are known as olfactory indicators. For example, the smell of onion diminishes in a base but remains the same in an acid. The smell of vanilla disappears when added to a base but remains intact when added to an acid. Lastly, clove oil, its smell cannot be detected in bases. This brings us to the end of the first part of this chapter. We will learn more and more about acids and bases in the next parts. Till then, happy learning and goodbye.